Hello students, in this lesson let us study about the hangers. We will see what are the different types of hangers majorly and what are the desirable locations in which hangers can be provided or the requirements which the hangers has to fulfill. The main function of the aircraft hangar is to provide an enclosure for housing and repairing of aircraft. So they are constructed from either your steel frame works covered with a galvanized iron sheet. So you can see here, these are the steel frame works and on top we have a galvanized iron sheets. So the service of the hangars are provided with the mechanic shops and the stores for spare parts of the aircraft which requires the repair. And the size of the hangar will normally depend upon the size of the aircraft that has to be used there and also the turning radius of the aircrafts. Because once they enter in, they have to come out, right? So in order to make sure that they turn properly, that much also provision should be provided. Normally, the number of services and storage hangars will depend upon the peak hour intensity of the air traffic at the airport and the demand of hangar on rental basis by the different airline agencies. Now it is necessary to provide adequate lighting inside the hangars. There are basically two types of hangars. One is the nose hangar and the other one is a T hangar. Now nose hangar is normally provided for the large size aircrafts. So they enclose only the forward portion of the aircraft. If you observe here, only the forward portion of the aircraft is only covered. A rear portion is not covered in this particular case. Such a design will provide suitable or comfortable working conditions for servicing the engine overhaul of the aircraft. Now it also proves to be economical. When it comes to T hangars, they are provided for small sized aircrafts. And the storage space is in such a way designed that the pilot can manoeuvre the aircraft in and out of the hangar without any assistance. He himself can go inside, he himself can come outside with just the vision. Normally, a minimum clearance of 30 centimeters should be provided in between the wall of the hangar and the aircraft. So this is the minimum clearance. So this is how your T hangars will look. See, if you observe, this is in the form of T shape. So adjacently like this, many T shapes will be there. The typical layout of a T shape hangar can be seen here. So if you observe, these are the T shape hangars, 3, 4, 5, like this, so on. This is one way traffic. If it is one way traffic, we have to have a minimum width of about 22.5 meters in between these two portions, and if it is a two-way traffic, we have to have a minimum distance of about 37.5 meters. Normally, any type of hangar should be positioned in such a way that they are near to the loading apron and the terminal building. So the apron position should be in such a way that it should be easily connected to the terminal building and it should link all the essential facilities like the water supply, drainage, electricity, and telephone. Also, it should have enough space to accommodate the vehicles of working professionals. So the next one is that it should have favorable topography so that you can provide a proper drainage system for your hangars. Okay, Favorable topography. The next one is that it should not be along the direction of frequent wind storms. So however your wind storms is there, in that direction your hangars should not be placed. So not along the direction of frequent wind storms. And finally, it should possess adequate scope for future expansion of the terminal building as well as the hangar facility. So if without future expansion idea, it cannot be possible for us to construct your hangars. So these are all the points which you have to consider when you are looking for the location of the hangars. So hope this lesson is clear to you now. Thank you.